Welcome to Framework Fortune Crypto. I'm your host, Ben, and apologies for missing yesterday's daily crypto update. The YouTube algorithm stole my hamster and is holding it for ransom currently, and I was trying to get it back all day yesterday, so I need you guys to help me teach that dirty algorithm a lesson and punch it right in the like button. Top story of the day, we have EOS. I am familiar with this crypto and actually invested in it. Been invested in it for a while. It's been on this nice uptrend. Finally had a little breakout there. And now we just pushed to some new highs currently as I'm recording this video. So if you look at it on the daily chart all the way back to May 19th of last year, because it has now broken this level of resistance that it tested three times before finally breaking, we want to see this hold up as support. So this 850 area needs to hold as support if EOS is going to continue on this run. If we go back to the 4-hour chart, you can see that this candle is holding above that resistance so far. So that is starting to act as some support. And if the support does hold, then we may get some type of triangle consolidation here or some type of U-shape up to that $9 area. If it can break 9, we could see it push up to 9.50 and even 10, maybe here by the end of the night. Dogecoin, the underdog that nobody ever expected to do anything, the meme coin of the internet, is making people millionaires as we speak. The massive rip all the way up to 65 cents and currently consolidating in a little bit of a triangle here on the 4-hour chart. If we see Dogecoin break above this resistance, that downtrend, Dogecoin will continue on up probably to that 70 cent area. Now it is way off of the trend line, so at some point it's got to start pulling back. People are going to start selling because they are going to be becoming richer and richer as this thing goes if they really went heavy on Dogecoin. I did go on Dogecoin really early on, but I did not go that heavy, so I made a little bit of money, but nothing to talk about like we're seeing pop all over social media. Now, of course, if a recent Dogecoin millionaire starts trying to sell you courses on YouTube, probably want to think about that before you make that purchase. On to the next coin. Ethereum broke this downtrend and is still climbing. Just hit new highs here in the past 8 hours, and it's currently consolidating, trying to build some support, some new support at this old resistance right here in this 3500 area. It's held up so far. Two candles in a row, it dropped below that 3500 support and got bought up and pushed back above it. So if this support continues to hold, then Ethereum could continue its run as well. Right now it's a little bit early to say because this consolidation is just now starting, but it's definitely worth keeping an eye on tonight and tomorrow. Litecoin, one of my biggest holdings and probably favorites of the coin, busting up over this previous high in April to a new high for May, all the way up to 365. You can see it was in this triangle back here. We were keeping an eye on it. If you were watching all last week, I mentioned Litecoin several times, and we got the big breakout, break of the downtrend, and you get this nice, big, massive rip, break over 300. And right now, kind of curling over, having a bit of a sell-off, needs to find some support. Looks like it may be trying to find support in this 347 area, but it's still early to tell. If it cannot hold these areas, could drop to 318, could drop all the way back down to the trend line. But more than likely, I think it will find support in this 330-ish area if it doesn't hold up here in the 345, 347. I would look for some type of U-shaped curl up right here to see Litecoin continue in the next 24 hours. Bitcoin, I'm sure if you're a big investor in Bitcoin, you're probably sweating a little bit because everything else is exploding and Bitcoin is not. However, Bitcoin is still in this big triangle. It did get rejected at the downtrend there. It's getting rejected there, but it is finding support in this 57 area, like 56.8, something like that. And if it can hold that up and make another little curl up, a little U-shape, it could break over that. And if this triangle breaks, I would say we will see a pretty big explosion up to the 65,000 area and maybe even push for new highs, because we are seeing a lot of coins hit new highs right now, like Ethereum. If it doesn't break, it's going to continue to follow this downtrend line back to the uptrend. But we'll be keeping a daily eye on Bitcoin, so we'll know every step of the way which way it's going. Waves broke out of its little triangle it was making. It actually broke to the downside, but ended up with a fake out, bear fake out there. Got the bears in a little trap, and the buyers proceeded to rip their heads off, as this ripped all the way from $30 to $42. Currently, we do have a nice looking triangle again. That last one is a little sketchy, so I would be careful, but as long as it holds in the triangle and keeps testing, it's tested multiple times recently, we could see waves continue to break out on its bullish move. Dash, another one of my choice coins in my portfolio, has jumped above this previous high recently at 411, hitting 420, is running into some major resistance for some reason at this 420, probably back on the chart on the daily, we will probably see that resistance. This curl over is kind of ugly, so it could have some more pullback in it left. This is a volatile coin because it has very low supply. So if a bunch of people decide that 410 is a good price for them to lock out, they're going to lock out and drop this significantly. And you can see that reflecting in the volume bars down here at the bottom, where we've had bigger sell-offs than we have in green volume bars. So I would like to see that volume dynamic change back to some green, some more buying, but it's got to fall down to a level where buyers will want to come in at. It may be trying to hold 390 as support. It looks like it's going to try to close above 390 on this candle. So if it does that, we maybe could see a curl around and then a rip back up. OKB, which was the other day's top story, went on a pretty massive run. This guy is just still kind of consolidating. It's not exactly the best looking flag, but it is somewhat of a flag because there is support in this 36, 37 area that has tried to hold up. If this downtrend continues though, and it doesn't break above it soon, and it keeps testing this support, we could see this pull back down to the next level of $34. Matic, which is another one of the breakout coins, has been consolidating sideways on the 4-hour chart. You can connect these pivot points right here to get the downtrend. It is kind of trying to break the downtrend at the moment. If it can break that downtrend, we could see it make its way up maybe to that dollar area finally. If it doesn't break, it'll just continue to ride this downtrend and pull back until it finds some area where people will want to buy it again. Where it's at currently, I would probably say look for it to be around 84 to 85 cents here in the next 4 to 8 hours. If it's not up there by then and it's still going down the downtrend, I would stay away from it for the time being. And one more coin to keep an eye on over the next couple of days or maybe even week, stmx. This is Stormx. Pretty cheap coin, only about 5 cents right now. It exploded back here in March from a penny all the way up to highs of 10 cents. It has been in a downtrend, but it recently hit the uptrend, bounced off, started to come back down again, but held in this support area of 46 cents. So we could see this start to get close to breaking out again. If it can break over this downtrend right here, where it got held up back here at 63 cents, then we could see another big bullish spike. So this is definitely one I would keep on watch for the next week or two. So that's all I got for you today. If there's any coins you would like me to cover on a daily or bi-daily basis, put it down in the comments below. Remember, smash that like button to teach that dirty algorithm a lesson. And if you haven't yet, consider subscribing to stay on your crypto journey with the Crypto Daily Updates. Till next time.